What's up, challengers? Welcome to the gym. My name is Gym Leader Gio, and this is the locker room. Week 4 of Season 6 of the GBA as the San Francisco Giants are team building for Yo Fizz and the Atlanta Hall Luchas. So on the left, you will see my draft 11. If you don't know them by now, they are Entei, Manaphy, Cresselia, Zapdos, Nidoking, Absol, Mega Absol, Miltank, Chestnut, Miss Magius, Ditto, and Regirock. On the right, you will see his team, which I have organized in an order based roughly on being most likely to least likely to bring in my eyes. They are the Volcanion, the Salamence, the Porygon 2, Gengar, Rhyperior, Mega Scizor, Electivire, Whimsicott, Zoroark, Hawlucha, and Masharna. And there's a little bit in there of a little difference in what the order might say versus how unsurprised I will be if some things come. So let's kind of talk about this a little bit before I go into the team. That's why you're staring at a blank screen right here, because I'm not showing the team just this very second. So the Volcanion is definitely coming. There's no way it doesn't. It does really well against my team. The Salamence is almost certainly coming because I don't have any Dragon Resists, and he's going to know that, and he's going to want to capitalize on that, which is why I have to figure out pretty quickly whether or not that's a defensive or an offensive Salamence. It could very easily be a Dragon Dance Salamence. It could very easily be a Scarfed Salamence. It could be Intimidate. It could be Moxie. All of this is stuff that I need to figure out pretty quickly. The Porygon 2 is just a solid all-around wall. A good switch into a lot of my offensive mons. Not all of them, but some of them. A good stall-out check to Cresselia if he wants to do that. And then we have the Gengar. Gengar, I have ranked so highly, but hold the phone here. The reason I think Gengar is I think he wants something really, truly effective at answering the Cresselia. And that's, it's either Gengar or Zoroark. So I have Zoroark much lower because I really don't think he would bring both. But he's probably going to bring one of them. And I think Gengar is more likely. It's faster. It hits harder. Zoroark, if he wants to play mind games. But Zoroark is always a little iffy because all it takes is one attack going the right way and it just kills Zoroark. So the Rhyperior, I'm really likely that he brings it. The issue with Rhyperior does really well against my team, and I'm suspecting a choice band this week because a lot of my Pokemon have a hard time OKOing it. And it can really put in work, so I have to play around that. The Mega Scizor. Mega Scizor is a great Pokemon. And against any other team, just incredible. But doesn't do great against my team. And I'll kind of go over that in a little bit. It wouldn't surprise me if it comes. It could be very likely, you know, well, I have to have a 6-mon and he tags it on there. Electivire is that same way. Electivire could be good to just try and scout out a little bit. Grab some momentum. It's pretty fast. Could be Scarfed. Could be Volt Switch. Could be physical. It's relatively nice to have for the Manaphy. And it wouldn't surprise me if he brings it, but I don't know that I think he will. The Whimsicott is a big question mark because some of the benefits of it are kind of lost. It's not strong enough to really threaten the Manaphy. I don't have any Dragon Stab, so it's not likely that he'll want the Fairy typing. I don't really have any Fighting type Pokemon. I mean, I have the Chestnut, but he's not really an offensive fighting type that you'd need that for. Could be a good check to the Mega Absol. I could see that. And maybe if he's fearing like a setup Mega Absol set, I could see that. But I don't really think it's going to come. The Zoroark, like I said, wouldn't surprise me one way or the other, but I think Gengar is more likely. The Hawlucha just offensively doesn't match up well against my team. It's got good speed, but it's, like, again, it's one of those mons. If he brings it, it's not gonna surprise me, but it doesn't really match up well, so I'm not sure what the purpose of it would be other than it being a super late game sweep opportunity for him. It's hard to say. And then Masharna, which is like a slightly worse version of P2. It doesn't beat Cresselia 1v1, and not really super defensively potent against anyone else on my team. So of his 11 Pokemon, 10 of them just would not surprise me at all. The Masharna, I would be surprised if it brings the Masharna. So let's go into what I was thinking this week and in my team prep. And I want to preface this by saying we have a plan this week, guys. We have an extra special plan. So in my team, in my practicing of all these battles that I've had with my front office, I was having really close matches. Fizz's team is very strong against my team, very strong. And I was winning, but I was never confident. It would always come down to these really crazy, like, endgame things. His offensive Mon can kind of pull through a lot of my Mon. There's a lot of predictions happening, and I didn't feel confident about it. You'll see that the matchups are not always in my favor this week. So I went to the drawing board and I said, Zapdos. And it said, yes, Gio. Zapdos is one of those Pokemon that doesn't just say its own name. Or maybe it does and I just hear everything he's trying to say. So it was like, Squaw, Zapdos, or something. And I was just like, oh yeah, I got you, bro. But Zapdos, I said, and he said, yes, Gio. I said, are you ready? And he said, he looked at his like little file, opens it just gently, like verifying that it's exactly what he had already agreed to. He closed the file. He's like, yeah, I'm ready. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the team that we brought this week, and this is precisely why he is ready. DDG, the Cresselia, Light Clay, Psychic, Reflect, Light Screen, and Moonlight, Decisions, a Choice Banded, Sacred Fire, Extreme Speed, Stone Edge, and Toxic. Baby Spice, the Surf, Ice Beam, Ancient Power, Tail Glow, Prince, the Earth Power, Flamethrower, Ice Beam, Focus Blast, Life Orb, Sheer Force, Dwayne, the Rock Tomb, Thunder Wave, Explosion, Stealth Rock, Custap, Berry, Running Sturdy, and Zap Zap, the Static, Thunderbolt, Roost, Agility, Baton Passer. You saw that right, ladies and gentlemen. This is the plan this week. Zap Zap needs to set up an Agility and Baton Pass to Prince. And here's why. There are precisely three Pokemon on his team that if they are running defensive sets, do not get O-code by Prince. Now, lots of his Pokemon outspeed Prince, but not at plus two, even with a scarf. With the current investment I have with Prince, I actually adjusted this slightly in game. It's like somewhere down here, maybe? I'm not exactly sure. I'd have to check my in-game mons that got gen, but roughly close to this with maybe just slightly higher HP investment. I can outspeed up to a Scarfed Hawlucha. That's not a common set, but it's a good benchmark to hit because it's his fastest. I think it's his fastest Pokemon. So at plus two, Prince is going to be outspeeding everything outside of Hawlucha if it's already activated its Unburden. So, the game plan this week is set up a little bit, take care of things I need to take care of, and then sweep with Prince. Now, there's a lot of stops to this. It's not just like, go in with Zap Zap, click Agility, Baton Pass, and win the game. It's not that simple. His team is far more complex than that. If this were a more standard opponent that's really just a lot of Pokemon either dealing damage or taking damage, just kind of bulky or kind of strong or kind of fast, it would be fine. But he's got a lot of weirdness on his team. And so let's go over the three Pokemon. I cannot kill a defensive Rhyperior set in one hit with a modest Earth Power from a Sheer Force, Life Orb, Nidoking. I can't. So I need to whittle down a Rhyperior a little bit. I cannot one-hit KO a Masharna, and it can have Psychic or Psy Shock, and that can kill Prince. So if Masharna comes, I don't think it will, but if it does, I need to be really careful about that. And a Porygon 2, obviously, it's very bulky, and I can barely three-hit KO it. So when it comes down to it, those are kind of my immediate stops to the sweep. So I'll have to make sure that kind of whittle them as best I can, lure them in, just have them take some damage, anything to kind of help me set up a little bit with Prince. The other things that stop it, the Whimsicott, again, not super likely that he brings it, but the big thing about Whimsicott is it learns two things, Taunt and Encore, and it's Prankster. So if it sees Zap Zap set up a set up an agility, it can just switch in the very next turn, and it can mess with things. It could encore the Nidoking. It could taunt the Zapdos to stop me from clicking agility or baton pass in the first place. It can mess with that. Lots of other Pokemon on his team have taunt. For example, the Hawlucha has taunt. The Gengar has taunt. The Zoroark has taunt. Is that it? I think that's it. Yeah, those are the Pokemon that have to... Oh no, the Evire. Evire, Whimsicott, Zoroark, and Hawlucha all have taunt. Fortunately for me, those are four Pokemon lower on the list of my expected brings that he's going to have this week. So it's maybe a moot point for me, but it's still something to be aware of. Other things to be aware of are Focus Sashes, because Prince is... defensively does not have a good matchup against this team, which is why the initial team that I built for this, the team that I was battling with that had answers to everything, didn't involve Prince, because it didn't outspeed enough things. The things it did outspeed, it wasn't OKOing and could put a lot of work into it in return. So I didn't like Prince originally, but I like him now. I love this idea, but unfortunately my front office were all busy when I came up with it, so I have not tested it. I have no idea how it will fare, but I feel pretty good about it, guys. I feel really good about it. So let's go over these sets a little bit more. Oh, there's a Focus Sash issue. Gengar is a potential Focus Sasher, a very likely Focus Sasher. Volcanion could be. I don't suspect it will be, because hazards are kind of an issue for it already, and you don't want to double that up by really introducing hazards being effective. Zoroark, because it's already going to force some crazy predictions, and so you can use that to your advantage. Whimsicott could also be a Focus Sasher. And finally, the Hawlucha, because you know, its defenses are really weak. It could very easily be brought down to its sash, which then activates and promotes Unburden for follow-up turns. So it's a good answer to Scarfers or this. So that is that's the initial read on what will and will not work for Nidoking. Zapdos, of course, is running Thunderbolt, Roost, Agility, Baton Pass. I really like having some electric coverage on my team, and the Roost, Agility, Baton Pass is, of course, what I need to set myself up to be in a good position to Baton Pass to that Prince. So let's go over everything else. DDG is here because one of the things I really want to have up is Reflect and Light Screen, so Zap has the turns necessary to get these setups off. It's going to be really important for me to have that on Prince, because if I don't set up in a great position, I need to make sure that I can survive some of those hits. So it's going to be very important for me to get that up pretty early. His set is relatively standard. Psychic, just to have something that hits most of his team pretty hard. Of course, it does not affect the Zoroark. But everything else is pretty much fine. The Dwayne is here. Now, I'm on the fence about Dwayne, but I think I'm going to bring Dwayne the Regirock Johnson. Here's why. Like I said before, those Focus Sashes, they're really hard to anticipate unless it's a Mon that always runs it, because you can kind of throw it on anything if you see a situation in which it would be useful. I'm running Rock Tomb, Thunder Wave, Explosion, Stealth Rock. A couple of reasons for this, and this went through a lot of iterations. The most important thing this week is the Stealth Rock, that I'm running sturdy with Max Attack and the Custat Berry. So I really want to lead with Dwayne. There's very few situations in which I won't, but the primary ones are if it looks like he's got an obvious Taunter as a lead option for him. But other than that, Dwayne's pretty good option for me. I can click Stealth Rock, and even if I'm in against something really bad as a lead option against me, like the Volcanion, it wouldn't be a great lead option for me. The Gengar wouldn't be a great lead option for me. Even the Mega Scizor wouldn't be a great lead option for me. I can say I don't care and click Stealth Rock anyway, and then activate the Custat Berry next turn. I could also click Thunder Wave on something, slow it down, get the Stealth Rocks up next turn, and do something like that. But that's the point there. Basically, Stealth Rock and Explosion to just quickly get over to DGG to set up these the Psychic, Reflect, Light Screen, and Moonlight, etc., etc. Decisions is there with enough speed investment to outspeed a max speed. Was it Scizor or Volcanion? It's one of those. It's one. Volcanion's base speed 70. Scizor is base speed 75. To add speed, a max speed Timid or Jolly, one of those. I can't remember right off the top of my head. And I, of course, will make sure I have those calcs up when I'm making those decisions in game. Good sizable HP investment, just because that's where I put the rest of it in. I don't need any special attack. Max attack, because I have to be shiny with a choice band. And that's kind of the set here. Sacred Fire is great against his team. The Rhyperior doesn't want to be burned. The Extreme Speed is going to be really helpful against some of his faster mons. Stone Edge is great, super effective coverage against a Volcanion, which I'll outspeed, and also hits the Salamence super effectively. If it's defensive, I can still get a super effective hit off against it. Baby Spice is my alternate Baton Pass recipient, because it also puts in a lot of work, and with its defense investment, same speed tier as the Decisions, is looking to be kind of a bulkier version of Prince. It can survive a couple of hits. The Surf is great and can take on most things. However, I need the Surf, of course. Does nothing to that Volcanion, which has Water Absorb and will just heal that HP back. So I had to have Ancient Power for that. I wanted super effective coverage, and while that coverage could have been in the form of some kind of hidden power, Ancient Power is a good alternative, because here's a situation you might first see. Something that's weak to Ice Beam that I'm in against, and it could anticipate the Ice Beam, like the Whimsicott, the Hawlucha, or the Salamence, and it's like, oh, I'm going to click Ice Beam. Then he could just go straight into Volcanion, and I do next to nothing to it because it's quad resisted. Same thing for the Surf. I'm in against the Rhyperior. He's like, oh, let's quad resist this. Goes straight into Volcanion, and he, not even quad resists, immunes my Surf. So I need something there to hit that Volcanion. Ancient Power is a good option. And the thing is if he does switch into Volcan against me, that's a free turn to Tail Glow. And if I get to +3/+2, then I'm in a really good spot also. So that's the purpose of the Baby Spice set. Great recipient to the Baton Pass from Zap Zap also. And that's my whole team here. I don't really want to talk too much about what I had on my alternate team set. I can tell you that the games that I was having were really fun, lots of predictions in there, but Fizz is a hard person to predict, and it's hard to play against someone that's difficult to predict. It's hard to play against someone who has a very different mindset than I have in playing the game, because I'm much worse at getting in their head. And his team is just really threatening, and there's so many Pokemon that he could bring that I wanted to take away that chance and set up a situation where it's like, okay, I know exactly what my plan is, and I need to activate that plan, initiate this plan, and if it pulls it through, then I know that I've got the victory. So that's the goal here, is weaken or remove any potential stops to Prince. So weaken that Rhyperior, weaken... maybe Toxic would be great. I don't have Toxic on anything, but weaken that Porygon to get any potential Focus Sashes broken by setting up those rocks, and just do my best to invoke a situation in which he has no choice but to switch in Mon after Mon that's going to get O-code by Prince. I need to set up that situation. I gotta be patient, and if I can do those things, he can't stop me. I mean, Prince really does Oko almost everything on his team. It's just Rhyperior, Masharna, and P2. And only Rhyperior and Masharna can Oko me back. So that's the game plan this week, guys. And I will see you guys tomorrow at the battle. And just to let you guys know, when you see this video and when you see the battle tomorrow, I'll actually be in Europe. So I'm not going to be able to respond to all of your messages. This battle, this team builder, this is all happening the day after I battled Tup, actually. So thank you, Fizz, for being really accommodating to my schedule. I know it's going to be really weird. I'm going to get back on the 11th, and you guys are going to be expecting a video on the 11th and the 12th, so I'm going to have to really quickly man mode out a couple of videos in that battle. My week 5 battle is going to be against Magnitude. No, it's not. Magnitude's just the owner of the team. It's going to be against... My week 5 battle is going to be against Battler X. That's who I'm going up against week 5. And he's got an interesting team also, and we're going to have to set up for that one also. So, as always, my name is Gym Leader Geo. You guys are the challengers. Thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.